The facial spaces of palm and anatomical basis of claw hand. So the competencies we are discussing are the facial spaces of palm and anatomical basis of claw hand. First we'll start with anatomical basis of claw hand. Clawing. What is clawing? Clawing of the ring and small fingers is the classical physical finding in the ulnar nerve palsy. In clawing, interphalangeal joints of fingers are flexed and metacarpophalangeal joints are hyperextended. Clawing occurs because metacarpophalangeal joint are hyperextended due to paralysis of interosseous muscles, that is palmar and dorsal interossei, and existence of normal flexor muscles and tendons, and existence of normal extensor muscles and tendons which are still functioning. And the fourth factor is interphalangeal joints are flexed due to loss of function of lumbricals. So all these factors, all the four factors mentioned above, allow long flexors and extensor to overcome the action of interossei and lumbrical and thus result in claw hand. Then we come to explain why infection occurs in facial spaces of palm. First we'll discuss the formation of spaces. In the hand, there is arrangement of fascia and also the septa which are arising from the fascia, that is palmar aponeurosis, how they help in the formation of spaces. And the spaces formed are of surgical importance because they may get infected. And in the picture you can see that it is like a cube, and we can see on the medial side, medial septum is there. On the lateral side, lateral septum is there. So they are the lateral and medial boundaries of the spaces formed. And there is one anterior wall and posterior wall. So you can see the posterior wall, and the opposite is the anterior wall. So any space in the hand will have one medial wall, one lateral wall, and one posterior wall and also anterior wall. Coming to boundaries of thenar and mid palmar space. First we'll discuss the medial boundary. From the medial border of palmar is aponeurosis. A septum, a fibrous septum arises, passes backward and is attached to the anterior border of fifth metacarpal bone. Then lateral boundary. From the lateral border of palmar aponeurosis, a second fibrous septum arises, passes backwards and gets attached to the anterior border of third metacarpal bone. Thus, this septum, that is lateral septum, or lateral septum which is arising from lateral border of palmar aponeurosis, divides the space in the palm into two spaces, that is lateral one is thenar space and the medial one is palmar space. Then we discuss the thenar space. Thenar space is very narrow and it has only one content, and the thenar space contains the first lumbrical. Then this space has anterior and posterior boundaries. This thenar space is posterior to long flexor tendons of index finger. So that makes the anterior boundary. And the space is in front of adductor pollicis muscle. So that forms the posterior boundary. Then we come to mid palmar space. Contents of mid palmar space are second, third and fourth lumbrical muscles. So this space also has got anterior and posterior boundaries. We can say that mid palmar space is posterior to long flexor tendons of middle ring and little fingers, that is 3 to 5 fingers. Thus it becomes anterior boundary. And this space lies in front of interossei, that is palmar interossei. And the 3rd, 5th, and 4th and 5th metacarpals. So these are the posterior boundaries, or the posterior wall. Then anatomical basis for infection. The infection of the mid palmar space may result from tenosynovitis of middle and ring fingers. And a web infection can spread proximally through lumbrical canals. Then coming to anatomical basis of treatment. When mid palmar space is infected, the space can be drained by an incision in either the 3rd or 4th web space, depending upon where the pus points maximum. Then we'll discuss another important space, that is the pulp space. It is present in the tips of the fingers. So the tips of fingers contain subcutaneous fat arranged in very, very tight compartments. And it is formed by fibrous septa, which pass from the skin to the periosteum of the terminal phalanx. The infection of the pulp space is known as Whitlow. As a result of pulp space inspection, if neglected in treatment, that is neglected Whitlow, may lead to necrosis of distal 4/5 of the terminal phalanx. That is due to occlusion of the vessel by tension in the pulp space infection, whereas only proximal 1/5 escapes because its artery does not traverse the fibrous septa. And in the picture shown, you can see the pulp space, that is the pulp of the finger. You can see the distal phalanx, and you can see the pulp space that is divided into different compartments by the fibrous septa that run from skin to the periosteum. And you can also see the artery which is entering, running proximal to distal, and you can see that proximal 4/5 of the finger is receiving, proximal 4/5 of the pulp is receiving the blood, whereas due to Whitlow, the distal 4/5 is cut off from the blood supply. Then coming to drainage, this condition is treated by giving an incision all along the lateral margin of the pulp of the finger. This will open all the compartments of the pulp space. Thank you.